Hello Chris here. In this video we're gonna make pillows like this in Blender. You can get the finished blend file on my Patreon. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, press the subscribe button and the bell icon below so that you won't miss any new videos when I release them. So first open Blender, then select everything like this, press delete to delete all of it, shift plus A, mesh, plane, select the plane, go to edit mode using tab, select everything using A key, right click, subdivide, then subdivide it 3 more times like this. Select everything using A key, E to extrude 0.03, enter. Then go to face selection mode. Alt left click on this edge to select this face loop. S to scale, Z to scale, 0, enter. Now we need to get rid of the double vertices. So select everything using A key, press M in the keyboard by distance. This will remove 64 vertices like this. Now we need to UV unwrap this before we apply a cloth modifier. So go to edge selection mode. Alt left like this edge to select this edge loop like this, right click, mark seam, then select everything using A key, U, unwrap, angle based. So if you go to UV editing workspace, as you can see, we got UV map like this. Then go to layout mode, G to move, Z to move, and I'm going to move it a tiny bit like this. You want the exact dimension, as you can see here. Now we need to add a plane so that we can use it as a ground. So shift plus A, mesh, plane. Now if we select this one, as you can see, if we press N in the keyboard, we have a dimension of 2x2x0.03. we don't want our pillow to be this large, so S to scale 0.25, enter. Now we need to apply the scale, Ctrl plus A, apply the scale, select this, press F2 in the keyboard, change the name to pillow. Select this one, press F2, change the name to ground. Press N to hide this window. Select this one, G to move, Y to move, and move it to here. We need to apply cloth modifier, so select this, go to physics properties, cloth. Then go here and enable the pressure and change this to 6. Now go to first frame, press play. As you can see, we have something like this. We need to add a collision to this plane, select this. Go to physics properties, add a collision. Then go to first frame, press play. As you can see, we got something like this. Currently, we don't have that many vertices on this one. So go to first frame, select this. We need to add a subdivision surface modifier. Go to modifier properties, add modifier, generate subdivision surface modifier. Increase both of these to 2. Then place this above the cloth modifier. Go to first frame, press play. As you can see, we have something like this. Pause the simulation. Then go to physics properties. As you can see, in the physical properties, we have a vertex mass of 0.3 kilogram, which means every single vertex of this cloth has a mass of 0.3 kilogram. So we can either reduce this mass or increase the pressure. So I'm going to reduce the mass, which is easier. So 0.01. Go to first frame again. Press play. As you can see, now the simulation is like this. Going to increase pressure a tiny bit. So go to here, 7. Then select this. I'm going to apply another subdivision modifier. Add modifier, generate subdivision surface modifier. Use this both to 1. Place this after the cloth modifier. Then go to physics properties. I'm going to increase the quality steps to 6. Then scroll down and change this collision quality to 4. Press play. Then we need to enable the shadow. So as you can see, there is a large space between the plane and the pillow. That's because if you select the plane, go to physics properties, this thickness outer is 0.02. Change this to 0.006. Then select this one. Then go to collisions and change the object to collision distance to 0.004. Then go to first frame, select this, right click, shade smooth, press play. Now we need to save this file. Before we do anything, save the Blender file. File, save. Now I'm going to duplicate this pillow as a backup before we apply the cloth modifier. Shift to D to duplicate, right click to cancel any movement, press M in the keyboard, new collection, change the collection name to pillow backup and create. I'm going to turn this off in the viewport on the render and exclude it in the view layer. Select this one. Now we need to bake the simulation. So go to physics properties, scroll down and go to cache. Then change the end frame to 150, then bake. If you press play, as you can see, we got something like this. I'm going to change this frame number to 150. Then select this one, go to modify properties, apply the subdivision modifier, then the cloth modifier. This subdivision modifier, we don't need to apply that. Go to first frame again, select this, shift to D to duplicate, Y to move along Y axis and move it to here. Select this one, go to edit mode using tab, go to edge select mode, select the middle edge, alt left click on this edge, then alt S in the keyboard and scale it to something like this. Then go to object mode again, select this, go to edit mode using tab, select the middle edge using alt left clicking on the middle edge like this, then alt S in the keyboard and scale it inwards like this. If you want the exact dimension, as you can see, it's like this. If you go to object mode, as you can see, we got two types of pillows like this. That's it for this video. If you like this video so far, please give a like to this video in the bottom. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, press the subscribe button and the bell icon below so that you won't miss any new videos when I release them. You can get the finished blend file on my Patreon link, which is provided in the description below. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye for now.